In this video, we are going to derive the phase margin. It means frequency domain response specifications. One of the specification is phase margin. So before going to derive the phase margin, so we should know what is mean by phase margin. So phase margin is the angle to be added with 180 degree to bring the unstable system to become stable. So now the angle to be added is the angle at which gain crossover frequency occurs. So angle at gain crossover frequency that will be added with 180 degree to bring the unstable system to stable system. That is the definition for phase margin. So we know the open loop transfer function of a second order system G of s equal to omega n square divided by s into s plus 2 eta omega n. So in this, for phase margin we considered open loop system, because in the open loop system we are going to add phi gc with 180 degree to bring the unstable system to stable system. So that's why we considered open loop system gain of second order system. So now according to the frequency domain specification, we have to substitute s equal to j omega. So here s, we have to substitute j omega. Next, so after that, so we are going to take omega n outside. So from this equation, we are going to take omega n outside. So if we take omega n outside, so here it will come omega n into, so here in the denominator, it will become omega n. So we have taken omega n outside. In the first term, omega n is not available. Therefore, in the denominator for the first term, omega n. So in the second term, omega n is available. Therefore, we have taken outside. So it will become 2 eta. So now what we are going to do? So this omega n, this square will cancel. Therefore, omega n divided by j omega into j omega divided by omega n plus 2 eta. So now we are going to bring this omega n in the denominator side. Therefore, we can write omega n in the denominator by 1 by omega n. Therefore, this term will become like this. So now we are going to consider for simplification u equal to omega divided by omega n. So we have to substitute into this equation. So now this omega divided by omega n will become u. This will become u. So now the magnitude, we are going to find the magnitude for this. To find the magnitude, so of real and imaginary, to find the magnitude of a complex system, so we have to take square root. We have to add square of a real value and imaginary value. And then commonly we have to take the square root. Therefore, so now this will become, so magnitude of this is j u the whole square. So magnitude means, so we have to square and take root. So we have to consider only real part. Therefore, it will become u. Similarly, this is real part, square root of real part square plus imaginary part square. So now for simplification, we are going to take this u into inside. So here u, if we take this u into within square root, it will become u square into this remaining terms. So then it will become 1 divided by square root of u power 4 plus 4 eta square u square. So now phase of, so now this is the magnitude. Actually for this equation the magnitude is this one, but for phase, actually this is one s term, this is another term. So this is in the denominator. For this alone, according to the concept, minus 90 degree. If s is in the numerator, means we have to use plus here, but this is here in the denominator, therefore use minus 90 degree. Then this is also in the denominator, again minus. This is having real part and imaginary part. Therefore tan inverse of imaginary part u divided by real part 2 eta. So this is the angle for, this is the angle for this complex system. So angle is minus 90 degree minus tan inverse of u divided by 2 eta. So we can consider this as angle, equation number 1. So now at gain crossover frequency omega gc, the magnitude of g of j omega is unity. So according to the concept, when gain crossover frequency occurs, the magnitude of g of j omega become unity. Therefore, actually we have to find the angle at which gain crossover frequency occurs. But at gain crossover frequency, magnitude of system equal to unity. Therefore, magnitude of system equal to unity when omega become omega gc, at the time u become ugc. Therefore, u equal to ugc, so its magnitude equal to 1. So now this equation, instead of u, we have to consider ugc. So here ugc whole power 4, here ugc square. So now here 1. So now if we compare these two, we can consider 1 by 1. So numerator 1 equal to 1, denominator also this term equal to 1. Therefore, square root of ugc power 4 plus 4 eta square ugc square equal to 1. So now we have to square on both the side. So it will become like this. So now we are going to bring this into left hand side. Therefore, ugc power 4 plus 4 eta square ugc minus 1 equal to 0. So now ugc power 4 plus 4 eta square ug square minus 1 equal to 0. So we are going to consider s equal to ugc square. So it will become x square plus 4 eta square x minus 1. So now this is your quadratic equation. To find the solution, we know already minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Here a equal to 1, b equal to 4 eta square, c equal to minus 1. We have to substitute into this equation. So minus b square root of b square, 4 eta square already b. So 16 eta power 4, this is 16, plus 4ac divided by 2a. So it will become like this, 2 into a 1. So now from this, here 16, here 4, we can take 4 commonly. So inside will be this. Then in this 4, we are going to take outside. Here already 4. If we take 4 outside, here it will become 2. Here we will take 2. So it will be commonly we can take 2. Inside will be minus 2 eta square plus or minus square root of 4 eta square plus 1 divided by 2. This term and this 2 and this 2 we can cancel. Finally, we will have minus 2 eta square plus or minus square root of 4 eta square plus 1. Now we are going to consider positive only. So ugc, we already know ugc equal to square root of x. To get ugc, we have to take the square root for the x. Therefore, for this term, we have to take the square root. Now, phase margin equal to eta 180 degree, angle to be added at omega equal to omega gc. It means at gain crossover frequency, we have to add some angle with 180 degree. So that is to bring the system unstable to stable. That is nothing but the phase margin. So now, substitute angle from equation 1 and 2. So eta equal to 180 degree plus, so EVC. Actually, this we already calculated. Angle of G of, so this is the angle G of J omega. So now, we have to substitute this angle into this equation. So it will become 180 degree plus minus 90 minus tan inverse of, instead of u, ugc divided by 2 eta. So therefore, we have to substitute ugc value. So ugc, just now we derived it. Ugc equal to square root of this term. So we have substituted. Then eta equal to 90 minus tan inverse of square root of minus 2 eta square plus square root of 4 eta power 4 plus 1 divided by 2 eta. So this is nothing but the phase margin.